Is Pioneer DJ dead? What the heck is Alpha Theta, and is the Omnis Duo, Opus Quad, Wave 8, and Euphonia Mixer worth it? So in this video, we'll tackle all those questions and give you the truth straight from Pioneer DJ themselves. But first, let's start things off with the Omnis Duo and Wave 8 1-month review. So here's my upfront conclusion. The Omnis Duo just works. From its portability, features, all the way to how responsive its operating system is and how each knob, fader, and button feels. Not to mention that it can last up to 8 hours on a single charge when in eco mode. This device for me is a solid deal for its price, and believe me, I have tried them all. As a technical scratch DJ, I had no trouble adjusting to this unit's workflow. Since it's so responsive and the layout pretty much has everything I need, DJing and using this thing right away was easy and fast. With that said, let's break things down and talk about the pros. The number one thing any DJ looks for in a standalone mobile controller like this is how responsive it is. I am surprised to say that the Omnis Duo is snappy and works amazingly well with my complex DJ workflow of quickly loading tracks, doing routines, and even scratching with them. Using this unit feels intuitive and responsive, and for its price tag, it does not disappoint. Any DJ can easily use this unit and figure out their workflow given its physical layout and interface. On that topic, the interface itself matches the aesthetic of the Omnis Duo, and everything is clearly labeled and rightfully sized. The 7-inch touchscreen is nice and bright, perfect for both daytime and nighttime play. Now, using this unit and accessing secondary functions such as jog mode, quantize, slip mode is intuitive, and that goes for the effects section as well, which we'll talk about later in the con section. The second thing that surprised me was how freeing it felt to use this unit without any wires, as the Omnis Duo is battery powered. It's stated on their website that this unit can power through a 5-hour set and can even go all the way up to 8 hours if used in eco mode. So this dims the screen a bit, but ensures that the Omnis Duo lasts as long as the Wave 8 speakers, which we'll talk about in a bit. Anyway, the Omnis Duo really shines when you take advantage of its Bluetooth capabilities, especially when you DJ with the Wave 8. Paired together, the Wave 8 Sonic feature guarantees a tight and seamless DJing experience with almost no latency. And from testing this out, it works pretty well. Before we move on to my favorite feature of the Omnis Duo, let's quickly talk about the Wave 8. So this is a brand new portable monitor speaker designed to be every mobile DJ's dream. Retailing for $899, this 8-inch monitor speaker features a Trode handle, wheels, high, mid, and low EQs, XLR line-ins, and more. The Wave 8 is also battery powered and can last up to 8 hours on a full charge. Aside from sounding great, it's also IP rated, meaning that it can get rained on and will be fine. Now, from testing this unit, what I really enjoyed is how seamlessly it works with the Omnis Duo. They pair up instantly, making the mobile DJing experience a whole lot less tedious. Now let's move on to the Omnis Duo's killer feature, and that's the input playback. What this does is essentially takes any audio track from a Bluetooth device, records it, and allows you to play it back fully as a mixable track. And that of course means that you can scratch with it, affect its tempo, make loops, add effects, and more. How does this work? Utilizing the Omnis Duo's built-in Bluetooth capabilities, you pair a device, such as a mobile phone or tablet, to the standalone. Once done, head over to the appropriate menu and hit the Send to Deck button. Now you can play the audio from your mobile device, be it a personal file or through a digital streaming platform like Spotify, YouTube, etc. And the Omnis Duo will take in this audio and store it in its system for playback live. In this video, I'm gonna give you a guide on how to DJ for complete beginners. This is perfect for mobile DJs who have sudden requests, want to play something that they forgot in their set, or even casual DJs who want to have some fun with their music. With this handy feature, you can add more and more to your set without ever having to worry about tediously transferring music from your computer. Before we move on to the cons, let's quickly talk about the unit's feel. For $1,499, you're gonna be expecting some quality. And the Omnis Duo does not disappoint. This standalone feels premium. The knobs and faders all feel amazing. The volume faders and cross fader feel buttery smooth. And the rubberized coating, while not the best for scratching on the jog wheels, feels absolutely stunning everywhere else, giving the Omnis Duo a distinct feel over all other controllers. I don't know if it's a paint job, coating, color or material use, but the designers at Alpha Theta really nailed it with this one. However, there are things of course that Alpha Theta didn't nail, and so let's move on to the cons. So my first gripe with the unit is the fact that the pads aren't RGB. As you can see, the Omnis Duo's performance pads are monochromatic. However, I do find the use of letters on each pad extremely useful, especially given the standalone's integration with Recordbox. And now let's talk about my biggest gripe with the Omnis Duo, and it's the lack of physical effects and loop buttons. To access those functions, like choosing an effect, selecting the deck you wish to activate an effect on, and making manual loops, you'll need to do so via the touchscreen. And with my style, this again makes things somewhat tricky. Don't get me wrong though, the effects can easily be triggered by the touchscreen, but the process of going through the menus and whatnot can get somewhat tedious. Not having that physical twist or touch feels less intuitive for me when it comes to doing my routines. Now of course, like any DJ, I can get used to this workflow and adjust accordingly. I just hope that maybe in time, we can remap some functions on the standalone controller through a firmware update. But the future is indeed bright with the Omnis Duo, with more features like streaming integration and throttle support coming soon. And I'm calling it now, the Omnis Duo is going to be a bestseller. Now speaking of bestsellers, Alpha Theta released the Omnis Duo hot off the heels of one of the most talked about releases of 2023, the Opus Quad, which by the way, is selling incredibly well. So after having this for over a year and putting it through the hoops, here's what I think about this all-in-one standalone, starting off with the cons. First, just like the Omnis Duo, the Opus Quad heavily relies on the built-in software to function, and therefore also lacks a physical effect selector for the decks. To select the different effects, you'll need to dive into the software via the touchscreen. Unlike many other standalone controllers, there's no way to quickly shuffle through effects, which again makes open format mixing and pulling off James type style of tricks a little bit trickier than usual. Second, this massive standalone lacks one thing that literally every other controller on the market has: performance pads and modes. Their function has been solely swept up by the hot cues on top of the jog wheels, and while some may find this totally fine, my preference for switching modes while doing my sets makes this glaring omission a major drawback for me. However, beyond that, the Opus Quad is amazing. For one, the quality of this controller is just premium. Featuring CDJ level jog wheels, smooth and buttery faders, an array of inputs and outputs, a very responsive and intuitive OS, and an aesthetic design that truly marries form and function. Overall, the only real problem I have with this standalone is the lack of physical effect selectors and performance pad modes, but that's solely based on my style of DJing. But for most pro DJs who prefer to mix in a more traditional manner, the Opus Quad is indeed an excellent all-in-one standalone controller. Now, an important aspect to consider with DJ gear is where you buy it and the quality of their after-sale service. When things go wrong, which eventually will, you'll want the situation to be fixed as soon as possible with no problems at all. That's why I get all my DJ gear from Sweetwater, such as the Opus Quad. And the reason being so is because they offer a free 2-year warranty as well as free shipping. So if anything goes wrong or if I need any help with it, I know I'll be taken care of, and so will the unit. Anyway, the next Alpha Theta DJ gear we have is the Euphonia Mixer, and let's quickly go through this. Keeping in line with being cutting edge, but also paying homage to the classics, the all-new Alpha Theta Euphonia is a hybrid rotary mixer. And rotary mixers are the precursors to the fader-infused DJMs we've all come to love in recent times. And as the title would suggest, have rotary knobs instead of faders. The Alpha Theta Euphonia is a 4-channel variant of that, which combines the quality of digital mixers with the rich sound produced by analog mixers of yore. This modern classic features 3 band EQ sections per channel, an echo section complete with different parameters, a VU type volume monitor, along with a master isolator section which allows you a degree of control over your tracks like never before. And this is all wrapped up in a sleek housing designed in conjunction with Rupert Neve Designs. The amazing thing about the Euphonia is that Alpha Theta put all their efforts into creating a mixer that really brings out the warmth of analog into the digital age of DJing. In addition to having all the bells and whistles, the Euphonia is also compatible with Rekordbox DJ and Serato DJ Pro. Personally, I really like it, even though it's not meant for DJs like myself. It just adds an extra level of variety to the DJ mixer market. Alright, let's clear things up. So back in 2019, this was the organizational structure. We had KKR, and KKR owns Pioneer DJ Corporation. And under Pioneer DJ Corporation, there were 5 brands: Pioneer Pro Audio, Pioneer DJ, Rekordbox, Kuvo, and Therese. So here's an illustration of the 2019 structure. Moving forward to 2020, in this year, Pioneer DJ Corporation changed its name to Alpha Theta, and Alpha Theta Corporation was then sold to Noritsu. So here's the current illustration. So what's happening now? Well, it's 2 things. First of all, Pioneer DJ is continuing as a brand. Products will still be released under its name. Secondly, there's a new brand under Alpha Theta Corporation, and that is Alpha Theta. And they're entering the DJ market with the Omnis Duo and Wave 8. Now you guys may be assuming that the vision of Pioneer DJ is now skewed, that they're going into a different direction and will no longer be the same with all this corporate restructuring. Wrong. To set your mind at ease, here's a picture I had with the CEO of Pioneer DJ and the CEO of Alpha Theta. That's right, it's the same person, Yoshinori Kataoka. And for the real Pioneer DJ nerds out there, Yoshinori-san is one of the engineers of the original CDJ 500 released in 1994. And speaking of engineers and geniuses, the same people making Pioneer DJ gear now are the same people making Alpha Theta gear. So the vision, quality, and direction is the same. Now this begs the question, who is the target audience for Alpha Theta? Is this brand just releasing experimental DJ stuff that diverges a bit away from what we're used to with Pioneer DJ's classical style of equipment? Well, not really, but maybe. The target audience for Alpha Theta is the same target audience for Pioneer DJ. They're just 2 different brands, and now you can gravitate to either which suits your preferences.